This activity is an application of the distance formula, and we're going to use that to find an approximate distance between two points on the globe. The points' positions are identified by latitude and longitude. The latitude is representing the y-coordinate, the longitude is representing the x-coordinate. This is a pictorial representation of latitude. The blue bands are above the equator, the red bands are below. And take note that above the equator are going to be positive values, below the equator are going to be negative values. The longitude as the x-coordinate radiates left and right from the prime meridian. Left of the prime meridian is west, which is going to be a negative value. East is right of the prime meridian, represented by a positive value. Here is a two-dimensional representation of the globe. And you notice that we have the prime meridian and the equator. Where those two lines intersect, we think of in our regular coordinate plane as the origin, and here it would be in agreement with 0 degrees, 0 degrees as the ordered pair representing that position. Any position in the plane as represented can be identified using an x and y coordinate pair. If I wanted to identify this position in the plane as is represented here, I would need to first from the origin move west. So I'm moving to the left. That's going to give me a negative number. And this band is identified by negative 45 degrees. So the negative is a direction. And then to move up to this position, I would be at 45 degrees. That would be how I represent that position in the plane. Now, in between these bands are portions of degrees known as minutes and seconds. The following example is a loose application of the distance formula using GPS coordinates. In this example, I've given you the latitude and longitude coordinates for Lake Sumter State College. This is actually the South Lake campus in Claremont. And an example position for the University of Kentucky at Lexington. The first thing I need to do is to convert these degree minutes seconds to just decimal degrees. And remember that we're going to use negative numbers for south and west directions. We're also told to convert our values to 3 decimal places. In order to do that conversion, I have to know that 60 minutes equals 1 degree and 3600 seconds equals 1 degree. So for the latitude of Lake Sumter State College, I'm going to have 28 because that is in degrees and then some decimal part to represent 33 minutes 4 seconds. To convert we'll start with the 4 seconds. 4 seconds to get the number of degrees, I'm going to take my equivalents here and I'm going to take the 4 and divide it by 3600 so that I end up with the number of seconds in a decimal number. So 4 divided by 3600. And I'm just going to look at that decimal number for the moment and convert my minutes to degrees, and then I'll have the decimal value for the latitude. Since the number of minutes is 33, I'm going to take 33 and divide it by 60 because there's 60 minutes in a degree, and I end up with the decimal approximation 0.55. So 33 minutes is equal to 0.55 degrees. 28 then plus 0.55 plus 0.00 and a repeating 1 gives me 28.55 and repeating 1s. I'm to round to 3 decimal places, so 28.551 is going to be my latitude in degrees from degree, minute, second. The longitude at 81 degrees, 42 minutes, 31 seconds west. So this is a west. That means I'm going to have a negative 81 point, whatever the 42 minutes, 31 seconds converts to. So 42 minutes is equal to how many degrees, and 31 seconds equals how many degrees. Same idea, 3,600 seconds to a degree. We'll do that one first. So 31 divided by 3,600 gives me that decimal approximation for the minutes or seconds in degrees, and then 42 divided by 60 gives me that. If I add that to 81, 81 plus 0.7 plus 0.0086 with repeating ones, I end up with 81.709. Remember, we're supposed to round to 3 decimal places. So 81.709. Sign is extremely important. We are west, therefore we need this indicated as a negative. Now would be a good time for you to pause the video. Come up with the decimal equivalents here into 3 decimal places for the University of Kentucky's positions that are given in latitude and longitude, degree, minute, second, in the information right here. So go ahead and do that and then resume the video. Now, if you've done this correctly, you found that the latitude for University of Kentucky, as is given in the degree, minute, second above, in decimal form is 38.039, and the longitude is negative 84.505. We're now going to take these values and convert them to a unit of measure in order to use our distance formula. So we're going to convert these measures to miles instead of degrees. We're going to multiply the latitude by 69.1 and the longitude by 53. Make sure you keep your sign. If I do that, taking the latitude, which is 28.551 for LSCC, Lake Sumter State College now, and multiply by 69.1 to convert that number to miles, I end up with 1972.874. For the longitude, I'm going to multiply by 53. Negative 81.709 times 53. And I know that the distance isn't represented by a negative number, or a unit of measure, I should say, in the number of miles. But remember, the negative is indicating a direction. Now would be a good time for you to pause the video and determine the number of miles, latitude, and longitude for the University of Kentucky. If you've done this correctly, you end up with 2628.495 and negative 4478.765. Now is when the distance formula comes in. We're going to take these number of miles and we're going to plug in our coordinates into the appropriate position in the distance formula. Remember, that's the square root of the difference in the x's squared plus the difference in the y's squared. The numbers are pretty large and we've got to be careful of our signs. Remember, longitude is x, so I'm going to start with that, negative 4330.577, and it would be plus the 4478.765, since we're subtracting a negative, squared. And then we're going to add the quantity 1972.874 minus 2628.495, that quantity squared, and get a decimal approximation. It says round to the nearest mile. If you do this correctly, you end up with 672 miles for this approximate distance. In the activity that you will do similar to this using the same concepts, you will be asked to go to two websites. One is MapQuest, the other one is fcc.gov. Follow the links as they are indicated in the handout to take you to the appropriate place. And then you're looking again, remember, for the distance between LSCC's Claremont campus and the University of Kentucky at Lexington. MapQuest, if you go navigate to that site and find the distance as indicated, you should come up with something approximately 801 miles. And if you go to fcc.gov, you will get approximately 675 miles. Now, the fcc.gov site is going to ask for degrees, minutes, seconds. And the MapQuest site is going to ask for actual physical location. So you'll need addresses here, and then you'll need the degrees, minutes, seconds for that one. Earlier, when we were converting from degrees to miles, I gave you some multipliers to use, the 69 and the 69.1 and 53. Those are approximations, and those numbers fluctuate as you move further away from the prime meridian and the equator. So you have to keep in mind that those numbers are not consistent from one location on what we're looking at as a plane to another. If you're interested in more information, you can visit these websites that are listed to find out more about the positioning on the globe.